Welcome to KidsAcademy.mobi.
Hello, everyone. Let's open the worksheet. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel. You can find the link to this app in the comments below. And today we're going to be solving some tricky division word problems with a worksheet called Sweet Division. Let's read the directions and get started right away. The directions say, solve the word problems. Whenever I read a word problem, I'm always going to underline important information. This way I can easily remember it and go back to the problem and find what I need really easy. Let's read the problem and underline some important information. There are 8 blueberry muffins. Max and Brian want to divide them equally on 2 plates. How many muffins will be on each plate? Check the correct answer. So I know that there's 8 muffins in total, and they want to share the muffins equally among 2 plates. Whenever I have a division problem like this, my first strategy is going to be to draw out the problem. So let's start by drawing out 2 plates. Plate 1 and plate 2. Now they want to put the muffins equally on each plate. So let's start by putting 1 muffin on 1 plate and then another muffin on the other plate and count the muffins until we reach 8, giving an equal number to each plate. Watch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Okay, that's 8 muffins. Let's count the number of muffins on each plate to see how many muffins there are on each plate. 1, 2, 3, 4 muffins on this plate, and on the other plate there's also 1, 2, 3, 4 muffins. I feel pretty comfortable saying that there are 4 muffins on each plate. But just to be sure, we should check our work using skip counting. To skip count in a division problem, we're going to write it out as we see it. 8 divided by 2. What that really means is how many 2s are inside of 8. So we can find that out by skip counting from the lower number 2 to the higher number 8. We'll keep track of how many times it takes us, and that will tell us what 8 divided by 2 really is. So let's skip count together. 2, 4, 6, and 8. Now let's count our fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4. 8 divided by 2 equals 4. And we still get our answer of 4. I feel pretty good that 8 divided by 2 equals 4. Let's take a look at the second problem and use those same 2 strategies. Remember, we're going to be underlining all the important information in the second question too. In the second question, it reads, there are 20 chocolate candies. So I'm going to underline that because that seems important. The children want to divide them equally into 4 boxes. So I'm already starting to think, 20 candies, 4 boxes, okay. How many chocolate candies will be in each box? Check the correct answer. Okay. So going back into the problem, I can see there are 4 boxes. So I'm going to go with drawing again. I'm going to draw my 4 boxes. Now it said that there are 20 chocolate candies in total. So I'm going to put 1 chocolate candy in each box, counting until I get to 20. Then we can see how many candies there are in each box. Let's draw and count together. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 1 candy in each box. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. We ended on the last box. So that makes me think there's an equal number of chocolate candies in each box. But let's count them just to be sure. In the first box, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 chocolate candies in the first box. I'm beginning to think the answer is 5. But let's check the last box just to be sure. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There are 5 chocolate candies in this box. I now am pretty sure that there are 5 chocolate candies in each box. But just to be really sure, let's check our work with skip counting again. We'll write out the problem, 20 divided by 4. And just like last time, we'll skip count by our lower number, 4, to our higher number, 20, to see how many 4s there really are inside of 20. Let's skip count. 4, 8, 12, 16, and 20. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 20 divided by 4 equals 5, and that matches up with my picture drawing. I'm pretty sure my answer is 5. 20 divided by 4 equals 5. Boys and girls, remember, when you're solving tricky division word problems, draw out your problem so you can clearly see the solution, and then check your work by skip counting. Great job, boys and girls. We'll see you next time.
Like us and subscribe to our channel. Find links to our apps and comments below.